What's going on, everybody? This is Mason. You are tuning into the YouTube channel Wasatch Pop. Guys, hope you're having a fantastic day. Fantastic week. Thank you for taking time out of your day to watch this video. Guys, say hello to Rudy. We haven't seen Rudy in a little bit. Can you say hi to the camera? Oh, that was a good hello. Well, anyways, guys, today's video, we are going to be hunting around Orange County, California at like kind of almost hidden gem Funko Pop shops. So Nick over at the Bands for Arms shop took me around to all the different places that he likes to go Funko Pop hunting and stuff like that to get things for his shop and everything and to help out other people in their collections and whatnot. And so I go around to those shops and we found some ridiculously cool things, and it's going to be a really awesome video. And at the end, I'll show you what I ended up picking up. But real quick, guys, if you want to go and check out my two other videos at the Bands for Arms shop and also my FunCon video where I actually went to FunCon, definitely go and check those out. If we get that FunCon video to 1,000 likes, I will be giving away this right here, the Rocketeer Pop from the actual convention itself. So there you guys go. If you want to go and check that out, get that to 1K likes, I'll be giving that away. All right, guys, without any further ado, let's get into the video.
Okay, so we're starting off at a place called Amazing Comics, and now I'm going to be doing a voiceover for this whole store because it was just so quiet that I didn't want it to be like super awkward, basically. So yeah, we were like the only ones in there, but anyways, right off the bat, I did find this from Jaws, which is Quint, and for retail, I'm definitely going to be picking this up because that's like a $30 to $40 pop, which I figured that's a pretty good find. Other than that, guys, we have some Pop Rocks, some icons, ad icons as well. Lots of really cool, like the selection in this store is absolutely insane. There's Pennywise right there, the original Pennywise. That's a fun one to see that you don't see super often. Some 007 pops, Little Shop of Horrors, another good one right there. But yeah, like I said, I'm gonna be picking up that Quint. But yeah, a good mix of stuff. Like there's some Masters of the Universe in there. There's some Fortnite, Overwatch, Rick and Morty, and other like animation as well. Those are really cool to see for sure. Dragon Ball Z, so you've got your anime covered over there as well. And then on this other side, guys, they have even more stuff. So a good mix of anime and Disney. And then we're passing Nick. Nick looks like he's made a pretty good haul over there with some Disney pops. He told me that Disney pops do really well in his shop, and that's some things that he likes to look out for. But DC is over here as well. So a good selection of those. Like I said, Nick's creating a good pile over there. And then we have some Marvel pops as well. There's that collector from the Guardians of the Galaxy. That's just an older one that you don't see very often anymore. So that is pretty cool to see. And yeah, there is Nick coming by with even some more pops. And then I ended up finding this one, Michael Emerson from the Lost Boys for 15 bucks. That's about a $50 pop. So I figured I'd pull the trigger on that one. Good for trade. And then over here they had a case of more valuable stuff. I love that Dark Phoenix that was up there. That one's a good one. Yo Gabba Gabba, those are pops you don't see very often. Some of the Beatles pops as well. Those are pretty cool. Muhammad Ali, Kobe Bryant. There was that Dirk Nowitzki too. That one is a definite high price pop for sure. And more Marvel stuff, good mixed in things there. And then over here they had some more Chases and other vaulted pops as well. Big Bang Theory, Walking Dead, Willy Wonka, American Horror Story. They got you covered, guys. They got a lot of good stuff to look at here. Taxi Driver, that was another really cool one to see. Kill Bill as well. But lots of really good things. And then they had this really cool statue of Batman. Figured I'd show that to you as well.
All right, guys. So Nick had to go to the restroom, but I'm here at Target. One in LA County, apparently. We're going to check it out. See if they've got anything good. So hopefully they do. That'd be awesome.
Yeah, guys, we're back here. I did find this. This is something different that I don't notice at my store. So the Flock Stitch. Nick, are you finding anything good? I know you just barely got here, so. Infinity and the Infinity Warps Iron Hammer. That's a good one. Homelander is another good one. But yeah, a bunch of Seinfeld stuff. I feel like I've seen tons of Seinfeld stuff. So, yeah. I mean, maybe we'll do a little bit more digging and see if there's anything else that's good. A couple of Team USA pops, like Scottie Pippen's back there. I did see Magic Johnson somewhere. But yeah, we'll keep looking around and see if there's anything good.
All right, guys. Next stop, we got Amazing Comics number 2. Let's check it out.
Hey, guys. Over here is where they have all their new release stuff. So I don't really know if there's really much to point out to you that you guys haven't seen in your own stores. Maybe some of the Hamilton pops are kind of cool down there. But if we look over there, there's a giant wall
Nick's already over there scouting it out, see if we can find some good ones. But yeah, let's see what they've got. All right, guys, I'm already finding some good stuff that I like. So we have a couple of the Pac-Man Pops, which I wonder, okay, 17 isn't terrible. Some of these ghosts, though, I'll have to see which ones, if there's one that I want. Clyde is a cool one. We'll have to maybe come back to that one. But 15 bucks, I feel like, is a pretty good deal on that. Bunch of, like, old video game pops over here. I'll keep looking through and I'll see if I can find any cool little hidden gems for you guys. But a bunch of ad icons. Ruth Bader Ginsburg. Rest in peace, Ruth. Awesome woman right there. But that's beside the point. We're looking at pops. Those are some pretty cool ones. My Little Pony. Those are some older ones. Don't really know much about them, obviously, because I don't watch the show. So I'm not a brony. Is that what they call it? But some old Hanna-Barbera, right? Yeah, Hanna-Barbera pops. Gigantor, El Kabong right there. So yeah, some definitely good ones right here for sure. Okay, I did find a Nickelodeon pop that I need, but I think I might pass on it. 20 bucks. Yeah, I'd rather pay retail for her. Some of these pops I know that have gone up in price, like the Digimon ones. Those are definitely ones that you guys should be on the lookout for, but Jetsons is another good one as well, George Jetson. But yeah, we'll look on the other side and see if there's anything else. All right, Nick, you finding any good ones so far?
No, not yet. There's a ton of old ones, though, for sure.
There's just a lot to really, like, look out for. That's the thing. It's like you could look at stuff and then just totally pass over things, so yeah. That's the hard thing. But a lot of Disney stuff, for sure, DC. Yeah, if you guys just want to take a peek, I mean, I'll keep looking, but I don't know. You scream at me in the video and let me know if I'm missing anything. But yeah, a bunch of Marvel right here too. Pretty sweet to see those. But yeah, guys, if I come across anything else, I'll definitely get it here in the video. Okay, so I figured I'd show off a couple of older ones that I found. So Lost is definitely an older show. Those are some older pops. Man in Black, Jack Shepard, Kate Austin, Golden Girls up there, Olivia Moore from iZombie. That's a cool one. They have some Battlestar Galactica up there. Older, Star Trek. I almost forgot what it was called. You have some Once Upon a Time pops up there. Some more Lost. Yeah, there's just like mixed in like good stuff here and there, which is really cool to see. What's this from? Oh, Alias. Okay. I was going to say Uncle Traveling Matt. That's another, I think that's a pretty solid one from Fraggle Rock. That's a cool set for sure. But yeah, like I said, there's just like mixed in vaulted ones here and there that are pretty cool. But yeah, we'll keep looking around. Like Orange is the New Black, Dr. Blake Downs, some of the Arrested Development pops are up there too. Those are pretty sweet. But yeah, definitely a really cool store, and I think that's probably about wrapping it up here as far as cool things that I found so far.
Okay, then they had a case of more valuable stuff, just like the last store. They had a lot of really cool things mixed in here. So there's some like Firefly pops, Battlestar Galactica, some more things, some more Lost pops, the original Friends set, which is really cool to see, some Pop Rocks that are down there as well. I think Tupac was there, but I'm cutting it off with my camera. You're welcome. And yeah, a good mix of really cool things. We're going to check out that other shelf in a second. But yeah, guys, some good Marvel grails in there with like the Phoenix and the Winter Soldier. I love the Sam Eagle and the Sesame Street pops. Those are really cool. You don't see those very often. Some more Pops Rocks, Daphne from Scooby-Doo, some anime grails, Disney grails. Lots of really cool things to look at for sure. And then on the back wall, this was mostly Chase's. Yeah, and if you guys want to take a look at that, definitely be my guest. But lots of really cool. The Superman Chase is definitely a good one as well. But there you guys go. Okay, guys, so we're at this mall. We're going to hit up a couple of stores. Hot Topic is going to be the first one. Let's see what they got. Hot Topic had some of the new Emily from The Corpse Bride, so the diamond one. That's cool. Blue Spirit. There was also Darkseid from the Justice League New Wave of Pops. And other than that, there were some Parks and Rec ones. And also that, a couple other Parks and Rec ones as well. But that was pretty much it for that Hot Topic. Pretty cool, though, to see at least some new pops there. Pretty sweet. So what's the name of this mall before I forget?
Oh, it is the Main Place Mall.
Main Place Mall. Okay. So what other stores? So we went to Hot Topic.
There's a GameStop.
There's
a Box Lunch where we're going right now.
Okay, Box Lunch.
And then this little shop called Anime Monster, which has a whole bunch of old Funko pops.
the pricing is ridiculous.
Okay, all right. So maybe we'll stop by there, but yeah, we're not 100% sure. But lots of cool places to see, so we're going to check them out. Okay, guys, so we're here at Box Lunch. We're looking at some of their new pops here. Kind of had some of the same stuff that they had at Hot Topic, but I do love the Sylvester and Tweety. That's one that I definitely need to get. The new Parks and Rec are ones that I need to get as well. Leslie the Riveter. There's also Duke Silver and Andy as well. And then Janet Snakehole. Couple of NBA pops that are mixed in here. I like Hakeem. That's a cool one as well. And then some White Castle ones. That one's pretty cool with the foodie pops. But yeah, there you guys go. There's some new stuff right there. And then we head into Anime Monster. A lot of really cool selection, just very overpriced. That Daffy Duck was like $70, which was crazy. Good thing I already have him, but a lot of cool animation stuff. This is where I gravitated to. Helga was like $20 right there, which I was going to pass on that. I wanted to get it for retail. But yeah, lots of cool things for sure. Just prices weren't where I thought they would be. A little bit above like Pop Price Guide, which, I mean, that's okay, I guess. But some sports pops, I thought this one was very interesting. Tony Hawk, has he gone up that much? On here it says he's $50, which I don't know if that's really entirely correct. But anyways, guys, that's Anime Monster for you. All right, guys, so next stop, Sick Pops. It's almost like a little house in a way. There's all these rooms that are full of pops. I wanted to mainly show off to you guys some of the more like quote-unquote grail pops here. Got a lot of really cool stuff, and I want to point out to you that Zero is really cool. Just some of the stuff that I noticed that is a little bit more expensive. I love the ad icons that are over here. Quisp is a really good one. There's also Count Chocula over there. Casper is a really cool one. Bunch of other stuff, some Freddy Funkos, TJ, that's a fun one. So if you guys just want to take a look and see some of the more expensive stuff that they have in these cases, lots of really fun stuff over here for sure. But yeah, we'll keep looking around and seeing what other stuff, but they have a really cool store, guys. I just wanted to show you this room first off specifically because just a lot of really cool stuff for sure. Okay, and in the rest of the store, they had a lot of music blaring, so I'm going to do a voiceover. But some more stuff in some cases over there, which are pretty cool to see. Then a couple Funko sodas, which I ended up picking up this Quake, and obviously wasn't a chase. But this is like their main room. Massive wall of pops, guys. Like wall-to-wall pops everywhere. Like, I don't really know if I can point out anything specifically to you guys, but there is just so much to look at. Yeah, it was sweet. And then they had a grail case up front, that bank robber Joker, Beavis and Butthead. Those are ones you don't see very often. What else? A couple of those Spider-Man pops, and then the Disney train set. All really cool pops for sure. All right, guys, we're back. So let me show you what I ended up picking up. So for the most part, I would say like it was a good mix of things that we found. I think my favorite stores that we went to, I want to say it was Amazing Comics. It seemed like their prices were pretty much retail. And then they had a couple of things mixed in there here and there that were like somewhat more valuable pops and stuff like that and grails. But I was still able to find some really good deals. And we also went to all the other stores, like we went to a Target and stuff, we went to Box Lunch, even a Hot Topic as well. And then there was that one ridiculously priced store, which they had a couple of good things mixed in like here and there, but overall the pricing was a little whack. But anyways, I found some pretty good deals at least on a couple pops. So guys, first off, I want to show off this is from Jaws, and this is Quint. So this whole set of Jaws pops, they came out in, oh my gosh, I'm gonna check on the bottom right here, 2019, and they are starting to creep up there in price. Now the three main guys that you can see right there, you got Quint, Matt, and Chief Brody. All those guys are definitely starting to creep up in price. This guy right here, I got for $10, and it's going for around anywhere between $30 to $35. So I figured this was a good one to get for a trade and everything, or even just for an auction or whatever. But I felt like, you know what, this was a really good pickup for retail. Who knows if it could keep going up in price. I always like to find those little gems, you know, that if I can get them for retail and I know that they are at a good price now, I imagine that they'd be even better in the future. So there's my first pickup right there from Jaws. We have Quint. Next up, guys, even better, I think this was probably the best one that I ended up finding and purchasing. This is right here, Michael Emerson from The Lost Boys. Now, I am trying to remember, I can see in my head who this character is or who the actor is. I know he's on The Goonies as well, but
Oh my gosh, his name just slipped me. Ah, okay, I had to look it up, guys. Corey Feldman, so that's the actor, I believe, that is for this character. But I got this for $15, guys, and it's going anywhere between 45 to even like 55 bucks. So Lost Boys is definitely a cult classic film, and you guys can see on the back right there all of those various different pops and stuff. I know that there's some exclusives that are mixed into there as well, but this gun, 2018, and I was surprised that it was still just chilling there on this shelf for like so cheap. I looked at it and everything, and there wasn't really any like dents or any like dings or anything like that. So for a pop that's been vaulted, you know, for a couple of years now, to get it pretty much at retail for the price that it's going for right now, absolutely insane, guys. And like I said, this will be up for trade or anything. So if this is something that you are interested in, definitely hit me up. But like I said, I always love to find these kind of pops out in the wild and then just kind of keep them for myself, you know, to see who else needs them or if we can get a cool trade out of it. I don't know. That's just something that I love about the Funko aspect of things, is that kind of thing. I guess I didn't really show this off, but in my previous video that I did, the Bands for Arm Shop, I did end up actually buying something, and I'll show it off on here. This is Doug from Up, and yeah, this is a really cool pop. This is definitely one that I slept on back in the day. I definitely could have gotten it for retail. There are a couple different versions of Doug. There's one with the cone, and then there's this one. I think there's a flocked one for Hot Topic, but I already put it in a pop protector. Nick gave me a pretty good deal on this. Usually what he does is he does pop price guide prices, and then he does a gift discount, depending on what it is, between 10 and 15%. And yeah, we got a pretty solid deal on this. I think this is gonna be going up in price here pretty soon with the new Doug Days series on Disney Plus. I mean, that's just my guess. Maybe that doesn't have an effect on it. But since there's gonna be more shows, or the show with Doug in it, who knows, maybe his pops could go up. But anyways, guys, I figured I'd show it off to you in this video, because I didn't show it off at the end of the last one. But overall, guys, that was a really fun hunt. I love going to different stores, especially the ones that are in my area, like in California and everything. It was a really solid hunt. And Nick, thank you so much for taking me around. I definitely do appreciate it, and having me in your shop and everything. I just want to give him a big shout out again, guys. Definitely go and check out the Bands for Arm Shop. Amazing Funko Pop shop, and it's just definitely worth a visit if you're in the Anaheim area. But yeah, guys, we saw some really cool things, and let me know in the comment section below, do you shop at any of those stores, or would you like to visit any of them? What pop did you see in the video that you thought I should have picked up, or would have been a really cool one that you wanted to get? Let me know in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. Be sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on any future videos like this one. Thank you so much for watching again. You guys are the best, like always. Remember to be kind of one another and always promote positivity, and I'll see you in the next video. Catch you guys later.